نستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Dear brothers and sisters, الإمام البخاري عليه رحمة الله, he narrated upon the authority of Sayyiduna Jabir ibn Abdullah radiyallahu anhuma that Amir al-Mu'mineen Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu used to say, كان عمر يقول رضي الله عنه أبو بكر سيدنا. أبو بكر is our chief, our leader, our master. وأعتق سيدنا, and he set free, he emancipated our chief, our master, our leader. This is in صحيح البخاري حديث 3754. عمر ابن الخطاب رضي الله عنه, Qurashi, from the tribe of Quraysh, radiyallahu anhu, he is just after Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, radiyallahu anhu, after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the first best person is Abu Bakr, radiyallahu anhu, then after him is Umar, radiyallahu anhu, wa ardahu, fi al-Jannah. Umar, radiyallahu anhu, shows humbleness, and he radiyallahu anhu gives status to Bilal radiyallahu anhu. As Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu, he set free many slaves, amongst them was Bilal radiyallahu anhu wa ardahu fil jannah. Bilal the Abyssinian, so he was an Abyssinian slave radiyallahu anhu, and then Umar radiyallahu anhu, Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu freed him. When Umar radiyallahu anhu, when he was stabbed towards the end of his life alayhi ridwan, he assigned six people, the people of Shura, to consult with themselves and consult with the Muslims to choose and elect and appoint a leader from amongst them. During that period, he assigned someone to lead the prayer, leading the salah in the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is a position of status, not anyone can get that. He assigned Suhayb ibn Sinan radiyallahu anhu, as authentically narrated in the Sahih of al-Imam Ibn Hibban. The Medina of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was filled with al-Muhajirin and the Ansar from the well-known tribes of Arabia. Yet Umar radiyallahu anhu assigns as an imam for the salah Suhayb ibn Sinan, well known for Ar-Rumi. They say that he is either from that area, from the Romans, or he was actually abducted or taken from the Arab land and was enslaved in the Roman land, and then he came back, or they brought him back and he was sold. In his biography, they say one of the famous men of Quraysh, Abdullah ibn Jud'an, was the one who bought him and he set him free. The point here that in al-Islam, what really matters is who you are and what you can do. The value of you, your value, lies within you, yourself. What is it that you can do? قيمة المرء ما كان يحسنه. It is referred a statement that they say that Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu used to say, وقيمة المرء ما قد كان يحسنه. The value of a person is that which he is able to do. There is no looking down upon any race. There is no looking down upon any roots or a certain background or country or whatever. What matters is al-Islam. What matters is what is it that you can do? What are your credentials? What are your qualifications? Are you fit for such and such post? Are you suitable for such and such position? That is really what matters. So we say that, and at the same time, we acknowledge the value that there are noble lineages. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed about himself, as in the Sahih of Imam Muslim, that he was chosen from the best of the best of the best of the humankind, alayhi as-salatu was-salam. So he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose Kinana from the children of Ismail, and he chose Quraysh from Kinana, and he chose Bani Hashim from Quraysh, and he chose me from Bani Hashim. Sahih Muslim, Hadith 2276. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, speaking about the qualities that the people look for in a wife, he spoke about four qualities. مالها حسبها جمالها ولدينها فاضفر بذات الدين تربت يداك. He said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, that people might want to marry a woman because of her money, because wealth, because of her background, her lineage, and because of her beauty, because of her deen. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم gave priority, of course, for the deen, the religion. However, if the other qualities are there, then there is something that truly the people do look for, and especially being connected, being related to the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-dawhatu al-nabawiyya alayhi as-salatu was-salam, then that is a great nobility. That is why it is established that Umar radiyallahu anhu, he proposed to the daughter of Ali radiyallahu anhu, Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu, Kulthum, to be married to her, because although the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam married his daughter Hafsa radiyallahu anha, still he wanted to be connected to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam by marrying the daughter of Ali radiyallahu anhu, and he did marry her. Ali radiallahu anhu gave her to him in marriage, and this shows that the enmity and the hatred and the things that some of the deviant sects claim about the companions and their relationship to the household of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all of that is fake. All of that is a hoax. All of that is just because they are deviant in their religion. That's why they accuse the companions of having such a thing. Otherwise, how is it that Ali radiallahu anhu will give his daughter in marriage to Umar radiallahu anhu? And if you look at the marriages that happened, you will see that that was happening a lot from all sides, which shows that they were not in a situation that they looked down on upon each other, or that they hated each other. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. So there is no place in Islam for looking down upon a certain race or a certain background, certain roots. However, we also recognize that the people, now we spoke about in terms of Rasulullah sallallahu and the family of the Prophet sallallahu and how they excel. Also, the humankind different nations. They come from different backgrounds. Yes, at the same time, they vary like the metals that Allah created vary in their value. This is how people are. People vary in their values like the metals that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created. They do differ, and there is a difference between them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, "Annasu ma'adi." The people are like the metals. كَمَعَادِنِ الْفِضَّةِ وَالذَّهَبِ. Like the metals of silver and gold. Rasulullah sallallahu, this is in Sahih Muslim, hadith 2638. Also, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once was asked by the companions as to مَنْ أَكْرَمُ النَّاسِ, who is the most noble. If one of you would be asked this question now, the answer would be the same as he answered alayhi as-salatu was-salam. Who is the most noble amongst the people? He answered, definitely atqahum, the most pious, the one who is most God-fearing. قَالُوا لَيْسَ عَنْ هَذَا نَسْأَلُكَ. They said, we're not asking about that. They are asking about the tribes, the people, their backgrounds. That's what they, the people. That's what they are asking about. So he answered again, Al-Kareem, Ibn al-Kareem, Ibn al-Kareem, Ibn al-Kareem. Yusuf, alayhi as-salatu was-salam, the son of Ya'qub, alayhi as-salatu was-salam, the son of Ishaq, alayhi as-salatu was-salam, the son of Ibrahim, Khalilullah, alayhi as-salatu was-salam. A prophet who comes from a lineage of prophets. How can you beat that type of a lineage? So, alayhi salatu wassalam, he mentioned Yusuf, alayhi salatu wassalam. Still, they said, laysa an hadha nas'aluk. We're not asking you about that. Qala fa'an ma'adin al-arabi tas'aluni. Then you are asking me about the roots, the origins, the ma'adin of the Arabs. Then he answered, alayhi salatu wassalam, خيارهم في الجاهلية خيارهم في الإسلام إذا فقهوا. This is in Bukhari and Muslim. The hadith in Sahih Bukhari is 33:83. He said, the best amongst them before Islam are the best of them after Islam if they learn the religion. If they learn the religion, back again to the piety, learning your deen and practicing it. Back again to the piety. However, even before Islam, the different people, they had different qualities. So and so type of people, they are generous. The others, they are not. So and so, they are hardworking. The others are not. And so on and so forth. Different people, they are like the different metals. So when talking about not looking down upon the roots, not looking down upon the races, not looking down upon someone or judging someone just based on his background, we are not saying at the same time that we are making everybody equal in every sense. That is not right. That is not correct. And from this aspect, this is where people get so sensitive. They either are overly sensitive about this, everything becomes to them, oh, you're racist, you're not, you know, you're arrogant, you're this, you're that. The other side, the other flip of the coin is being completely desensitized towards this issue and valuing the people, giving them their worth, not because of their backgrounds or their roots, giving them their value as what they are and as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that the noble amongst us is the one who is the most pious. So that is another point. Another point is kullu khalqillahi hasan. Kullu khalqillahi hasan. Do not look down upon yourself, upon your roots, upon your backgrounds. Especially the young amongst us who come to this land or even being born in this land, and they look back about where their roots are from. Some of them Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided them to value the religion of Islam. And they know and they are proud and they are happy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them Muslims, either Muslims by birth or they accepted Islam later. So they value this ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But others are not like that. And they look down upon their roots, their backgrounds, where their family came from, their color, their shape, the way they look. This man from the companions, as it is known, it is the sunnah that you shorten your thobe. So this man, he had legs, shins, saqeen, that are somewhat crooked. So he was dragging. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded him to raise up his thawb. And he was not doing that, saying that his shins, saqeen, are crooked. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, كُلُّ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ حَسَنٌ. All of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the human being في أحسن تقويم, in the best fashion. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored the son of Adam. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي Adam. We honored the children of Adam عليه الصلاة والسلام. And all of us, all the humans, go back to actually Adam عليه الصلاة والسلام. And we are told in the authentic hadith, we are told in the authentic hadith in the Sunan, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created Adam من قبضة قبضها من جميع الأرض. He created him from a grip of dust that he took from all of the dust of the earth. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explains that this is why and this is how the different people came into different colors and shapes. Some of them are easygoing, some of them are hard and tough, like the earth. Some part you need to climb, some like a mountain, and some like a valley. You can walk easy on it. Some of it is good, some of it is not good, right? Not as good. So this is how the people came, and they came, all of them, from Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Do not look down upon yourself and who you are. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose this for you. ارضى بما قسم الله لك. Be happy with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destined and pre-planned for you. You did not choose who your father was. You did not choose who your mother was. You did not choose where to be born, the place of birth. You did not choose that yourself. So definitely there is no blame whatsoever. You cannot be blamed whatsoever for the way you look or your background. You had no say in it whatsoever. So it is okay even for you to feel proud and to feel honored that you know your roots and you can refer and trace yourself back to your fathers and your forefathers. Rather, the one who disowns his roots, the one who disowns his forefathers, is someone who is cursed in Al-Islam, as in the authentic hadith, that the one who does not want to refer himself, intafa, he does not want to refer himself in lineage to his forefather, then عليه لعنة الله والملائكة والناس أجمعين. Upon him is the curse of Allah, the angels, and all of the people. It is okay to feel good about where you are from or who your ancestors are. It is okay. It is okay to feel like that. But of course, what you should be always be proud the most with is the fact that you are a Muslim. The fact that you are a followers of the religion of Islam, the religion of all of the prophets. All of the prophets were upon the religion of Islam. Many places in the Quran you find the disciples, you find the followers of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, you find Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, you find Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam telling his children before he dies that die not except as Muslimun. All of them, they say, Al-Islam, Al-Islam, Al-Islam. Islam is just one religion. There are no heavenly revealed religions. There is only one religion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, and that is the religion of Al-Islam. There were different legislations. Yes, every prophet or the different prophets may have had different legislations, but the religion of Al-Islam is just one. Not only the prophets are saying that, even those who received the messages of these prophets and they refused and rejected these messages, they recognize that. You have Fir'aun, فَلَمَّا أَدْرَكَهُ الْغَرَقُ قَالَ آمَنْتُ. When he was about to drown, he said, آمَنْتُ, آمَنْتُ, I believe. I believe what? That there is no true God except the one that the children of Israel believed in. لا إله إلا الذي آمنت به بنو إسرائيل. He says, وَأَنَا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Pharaoh, I am of the Muslims. He did not say, I am from the Jewish people. I am from the Jews, من اليهود أو المتهودين. He did not say that. He said, I am of the Muslimin. I am of the Muslimin. This is what we need to be proud of the most. This is number one, to be proud of the fact that we are Muslims, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made us Muslims. That is the greatest favor. أقول قولي هذا. أستغفر الله لي. الحمد لله رب العالمين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما صليت على آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما باركت على آل إبراهيم، إنك حميد مجيد. Dear brothers and sisters, although we do not deny the value of the noble background, the noble lineage, the noble ancestors, at the same time, we do not just depend on that, as what matters is really the righteousness and the piety, at-taqwa. The son of Nuh, alayhi salatu wasalam, was not a believer. The father of Ibrahim al-Khalil, alayhi salatu wasalam, was not a believer. The uncle, the paternal uncle who defended the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Talib, he died as a non-believer. So it is true that يعني هذا الشبل من ذاك الأسد, as they say, this cub is from that lion, right? There is, it's like a tradition within the families. They make sure this is the value of the family in Islam and how it is much cherished. It is a mithaqun ghaleez, it's a heavy covenant, the marriage. And from that you produce righteous children and righteous grandchildren, righteous grandchildren. And still the families care about that. That's why the family is important. But at the same time, you cannot guide whomever you wish. إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتِ. You do not guide whomever you love. So those who stray away from good and noble families, righteous families, those who stray away and choose disbelief, yes, we invite them, we try to advise them, we do our best to make them change course and be a good Muslim. If they chose otherwise, they have chosen for themselves. And there is no one that is to be shamed or looked at with disgrace if someone strayed away from the family. We cannot shame those families because of these people. Because Allah has given them the choice. They made the wrong choice. They made the wrong choice. So we in Al-Islam, we once again value the family and value what is produced from the family, but at the same time, we do not look down, we do not disgrace, we do not shame those families that have individuals that chose to stray away from or deviate from the religion. Lastly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as in the Quran, هو الذي أرسل, he is the one who sent عليه الصلاة, the messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام في الأميين رسولا منهم. He sent within the unlettered a messenger from within them. يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمْ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ, reciting to them his book, he purifies them and he teaches them the book and the wisdom. وَإِنْ كَانُوا مِنْ قَبْلُ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ, and when they used to be before in manifest error. وَآخَرِينَ مِنْهُمْ لَمَّا يَلْحَقُ بِهِمْ, Allah spoke about others from them, others from them, from those who accepted Islam. There are others that will come later on. لَمَّا يَلْحَقُوا بِهِمْ, they did not reach them, they did not reach the level of the Sahaba, they did not reach them in time, they did not reach them in excellence and value. The Sahaba, they are the best of this ummah, the companions of Rasulullah, they are the best. But then there are people that will come, as in the Quran, that will be Muslims, and they will be from those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen. وَذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَضْلُ الْعَظِيمُ, that is the great excellence. آخَرِينَ مِنْهُمْ لَمَّا يَلْحَقُوا بِهِمْ, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked about those who will be coming later on, who are they? Who are they? As in Bukhari, hadith 4897, and also in Sahih Muslim, he said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, and he put his hand on Salman al-Farisi, Salman the person. He said, لو كان الإيمان في الثريا, if Iman was in the ثريا, this is a star that is very high in the sky, then لتناوله رجال من هؤلاء, أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام, then people, men like him, they will grab onto it. Grab on al-Iman, which is very far away in the sky. This is talking about Arabs and Ajam, Arabs and non-Arabs, that will come later on, that will hold on to the faith, hold on to al-Islam, and stick to it, and invite to it. And this is exactly what happened. And still to this day, we have those Muslims who are striving hard to practice their deen. They believe in it, they value it, they cherish it. It is number one for them, is their religion. Number one is their religion. They are still existing. Yes, we have a lot of Muslims around the world who are going through a lot of hardship. Different places. I don't have to name the countries, because I might forget one country where almost there isn't a country that, yani, we're not going through hardship. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relieve the distress of the Muslims everywhere. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relieve the distress of the Muslims everywhere. However, at the same time, we feel sad about this. At the same time, we say, alhamdulillah, that they are Muslims. Even if they die, their end is paradise. Even if they go through some sort of difficulties, that will cut down, that will reduce, that will wash away the sins that they have committed in this world. We need to try to help them as much as we can, at least with having them on our mind in our dua. When you make dua, do not just make dua for yourself. Make dua for those Muslims that are in distress around the world. اللهم نجي المستضعفين من المؤمنين. اللهم ادخلهم مدخل صدق واخرجهم مخرج صدق واجعل لهم من لدنك سلطانا نصيرا. اللهم عليك بعدوك وعدوهم. اللهم احصهم عددا واقتلهم بددا ولا تغادر منهم احدا واجعل اللهم تدبيرهم تدميرهم واجعل دائرة السوء تدور عليهم. اللهم أعنا ولا تعين علينا وانصرنا ولا تنصر علينا وامكر لنا ولا تمكر علينا واهدنا ويسر الهدى إلينا وانصرنا على من بغى علينا. اللهم اجعلنا لك ذكارين لك شكارين لك رهابين لك مطواعين لك مخبتين إليك أواهين منيبين. ربنا تقبل توبتنا واغسل حوبتنا وأجب دعوتنا وسدد ألسنتنا واسلل سخيمة صدورنا. اللهم واسلل سخيمة صدورنا. اللهم اهدنا لأحسن الأخلاق والأعمال، لا يهدي لأحسنها إلا أنت، واصرف عنا سيئ الأخلاق والأعمال، لا يصرف عنا سيئها إلا أنت. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن له حق علينا، وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وقنا الصلاة.